My name is Rashmi Ranjan. I am also from Bokaro itself. In 2000, I did my class 12th. I was the product of MGM Bokaro. After that, I did my triple IT, All India ranks, AIMs, and other things. In 2016, I started this project called UDAN. Why did I start a project called UDAN? I'll be going through the slides. I'll be sharing it with you. And why I have brought this project to Bokaro, I'll go in details. But before that, any idea, have you ever heard about the project called UDAN? How many of you have heard about UDAN? One, two. Don't look at others. If you have genuinely heard about it, okay, so what is UDAN? Can someone tell me? You have heard about UDAN. So what is UDAN? Now the friends are pinpointing. So usne kaha tha ki use pata hai. Now you explain. So, yeah, please. So we are starting the program and we have already started it. So if you have heard about it, dear students, I'll tell you. The main reason for starting this project UDAN was, it goes back to my school days and the inspiration which I have extracted from there. The observations which I have seen in this society, in this Bokaro, I was born, brought up, everything out here. So I could understand the pain areas of the student and I could see the deteriorating educational standard in the country. I was there in US, I could hear people of India, the Indian people talking their nuisance about Indian educational system, talking, hello sir, very good. I could see there that the Indian people who are like doctors and engineers in America, they are really talking very pathetic about the Indian educational system and maybe the Indian political system, the socio-economic culture, everything out there. And they were, you know, it goes back to year 2007 and 8 when I was there in US and a couple of doctors were saying, Mr. Ranjan, India mein mahol nahi hai aage badhne ka. That was what they were telling me. And when I was back to the country, I could hear people complaining about there is no right environment, you know, that word which they call mahol is not there persisting in the country. Then I was astonished. I felt, what is this word called mahol or environment and who is responsible to create it? Who is responsible to make this mahol or the environment, the right environment? Who is responsible? Tell me. We? Or who is responsible? Leaders? Actors, politicians, sports person, or we as a citizen of this country? Who? We. Loud and clear? We? Or someone has a different opinion? Hami log hai na zimmedar uske liye. So that is what inspired me and I created this project called UDAN, which the concept of UDAN is change management for all. You know, and when I talk about change, what do you exactly understand when I talk about change? Because now, next year when you all will be giving your board exams, after that, I think you all will be touching the age of 18 approximately. And then you will all have the voting rights. Okay. And choosing your own leaders. And then choosing your own streams where you want to build your career. So how many of you think that you have the decision-making rights in your hand? How many of you really think that in your family, you have got the right to take your own decision related to the career? How many of you? Freely, don't look at each other. If you feel that, be honest, because this is all about, there is no pointing or grading system out here that, okay, how many of you have raised the hand, Honorable VP sir will be rating, okay, these guys are self-sufficient. No, nothing. It's an open poll which will help me to interact with you better. Dear students, in year 2000 when I did my class 12th, believe me, I really wanted to be a cricketer. My second brother wanted to be a writer and third one wanted to be a fashion designer or a model. But we all three ended up being an engineer from the top college and after that being a management consultants, you know. And today we are all pursuing our dreams trying to, you know, but then we have nothing to blame to our parents because that is what was prevalent at that time. That is what our parents really wanted us because they felt engineering is the best destination for any student to, you know, have a stable career ahead and to make his or her life, you know, secure or medical, you know, that is what was the general perception. But when, I'm sure you all have watched Three Idiots, yeah? How many of you have not watched Three Idiots? Only one? Okay. If you have not, do watch it. And who have watched it out, just you can remember. There we were talking about, you know, there is a college kind of thing, and which was giving the more, the entire moral of the film was what? Can someone just give a synopsis? What was the moral of the film? When you have watched it out, what did you understand from that film? In your own words, I don't mind. I mean, see, you have watched something. Now you have to recollect. I'll tell you why I'm, you know, I'm emphasizing, and my training programs, which I do it for schools, colleges, IITs, government sectors like Coal India, Postal Department, Indian Postal Department, and so many. Why I use animations, videos, and all? Because audiovisual happens to be the, you know, to have the maximum impact on one's, you know, memory power, or maybe it helps them to connect emotionally at times. So I'm, since Three Idiots was the most popular film of that, you know, till today, I would definitely like all of you to connect to that film. And because, you know, the PowerPoints which I'm going to run is going to be associated with an agenda. The certain agendas need to be clear to all of you, because you all are class 12 students. And you need to be very clear, because that was the story about three guys who have entered an engineering college after passing their 12th, of course. And they have chosen the engineering maybe by, maybe not by choice, but by compulsion. Okay? So I'm sure you all would not like to end up in the same scenario, you know, forced up by your parents. Farhan was a character out there who wanted to be a wildlife photographer, but he ended up being an engineer by his, you know, with sheer force and pressure from his father. But then somewhere in the middle of the film, by the end of the year, he realizes he can't push it any longer, and he needs to be, hear his own heart and his own consciousness. So why don't, before you jump or plunge into a career, why are you not clear about it? So what was the moral of the film? I will again repeat. I'm sure the film was very simple and clear to everyone. I don't think it needs too much, under, you know, pondering over the film that, okay, what was the moral of the film? Let me connect. Or should I help you out? Because that is very important for all of you to remember. What was the Three Idiots film all about? Dreams, okay. Elaborate it better. What kind of dreams? Professional, okay. So the character in the film, there are three characters, okay. There is a college, there is a principal out there. What does he say? Anything you can remember what he says? Life is a? Okay. If you don't run, you know, you will be left behind. That is what he teaches, because that is what is the fundamental of today's educational system. So dear students, you need to understand, we are all in a rat and a cat race in today's scenario. And in that, somewhere, we have forgotten our basic ethics, the happiness. You know, happiness, what brings happiness in our life? So we should choose a career, you know, which should really motivate us. When I was working, you know, people ask me, Mr. Ranjan, what has changed after you have started UDAN? You were working on a high package with companies. Now today you have started your own project. What has changed? I said, I used to work for 10, 12 hours for others. Today I work for 18 hours. That is, that has only changed. I was enjoying my work, but I am further enjoying my work. I am far happy than what I was doing maybe 2 years back. Because this has come from my own heart. This is my baby, I can say. This is my brainchild. So something which is coming from your heart, I am sure you will give everything to it to make it happen. And believe me, ultimately, what parents also want is your happiness. But they are confused because they are hearing so many things in the society. Ki jisne engineering nahi kiya, wo job, wo America nahi ja paega, wo nahi. You know, I became engineer, but then I didn't went for engineering to America. I went for marketing, business and business development, which is very rare for the people from India to go. Software engineers, I'm sure you all know, they go to America. But I was sent for marketing. So that you have to first of all realize, if I ask any five of you, please, what is your dream in life to become? Please, love. Engineer. Okay, since we are talking about engineering, so engineer, or DPS is known for producing so many IITians and all, that is why engineer? Why? I mean, truly you want to be an engineer? from the core of the heart, you really want to be an engineer? Okay, nice. Please, you.
Architecture.
Architecture, okay. You truly want, I'm sure you all, what you are saying is not through an influence, but by your own. Great. You, what do you want to become in life? Yeah, you. Engineer, okay, great. At the back, someone who feels they don't want to be an engineer, something else? Anyone? So in the class, everyone wants to be an engineer only? So I should assume that in DPS, yeah, yes, please. Please tell me. Okay, so you feel that engineering is the first platform where you can become stable and then you can fulfill your dream. Please be seated. Thank you. That was, I think, an honest answer. I think that was an honest answer which I can, you know what? I have been born, brought up here in this society. I know the psychology of this society much better than all of you. When I was growing up, my parents, you know, we are three brothers, we all three, as I told you, are engineers, MBA. We were told by our father, if you don't, you know, see that guy is an IIT and he's from Roorkee and all. But believe me, let me tell you all, when we are trying to copy others, we are under a peer pressure. We are under the pressure of the society. And what is the current scenario? Let's go through the PowerPoint presentation. Why UDAN is the need for education, corporate and government sector. And I'm sure you all will get clear about it. This is the current scenario. Till 2016, the highest unemployment in the country, 6.40%, which is highest in last 5 to 6 years. Okay, and I'll come to the statistics of what is the growing unemployment. I'm sure you're all aware about the growing unemployment in the country. Okay, and it talks about China giving 800 million youth population the job out of 1,000 million youth population, whereas India, out of 850 million working population, only 450 million could get the job. Third point talks about automation. Do you have any idea about automation? AI, how many of you have heard about AI, artificial intelligence? Okay, robotics, AI, you know, machines being taught, they are being translated into an expert system where they will be doing the job of a mankind, a human being. So automation is threatening how many percentage? 69% of the jobs in India. Only creative jobs would be left behind, you know. And Asia Pacific report talks about the growing unemployment, and from 1991 to 2000, less than half of the new entrants in the job market. Now let me tell you about engineering. It is the most talked about job. But let me tell you very clearly, my dear students. Every year, approximately 29 lakh students get admitted into the engineering stream. 15 lakh students every year pass out their engineering. While as per the 2016 rating, I mean survey, approximately 4.5 lakh engineering jobs were available in the country. And I'm not going to only tell you the problems, I'll also guide you with the solutions. But before knowing the solution, you need to understand what is the challenge. Believe me, whole India, you know, and we will be talking about how many colleges and all this is as per the 2016 research and all. And mine is a research-oriented program. And I talk about, and this is not the full-fledged program, I'm just giving you the introduction of this program. You know, once you understand the importance of this program in next hour, we will be doing a full-fledged, 3 to 4 hours full-fledged programs where you will be given the complete information. Okay, that is called Foundation Program in Change Management. More than 10,000, as I said, participants have attended this program, out of which 7,000 plus are students only. Okay? So when we talk about that, next, Wipro, 47,000 jobs they have declared already are going to be lost in next 3 years' time. Okay? Infosys has already released 9,000 employees. It has been now more than that due to automation. Bringing the machine into the work culture will reduce the manpower. There has been a huge, you know, hue and cry around automation, whether automation should be accepted or not, robotics or the machine should replace the mankind or not. There is a lot of hue and cry around it. Mr. Bill Gates has opposed the use. He has even said that robots should pay the taxes as they are replacing the job of the mankind. Okay, so that up to that level the statements have come. Dear students, you are, if you are going into the job market, go with full preparation, with a right kind of mindset, which should end up giving you a good and a stable job, not making you a failure in your own eyes, that okay, I failed in my life. Failure is the most devastating word in one's life. And you know what? Failure is the word which only comes when you find no way in your life, whether you have to go right or left, you are totally confused. There is no one who can actually guide you. You are not aware about your own talent. Just because your father, mother, sister, brother have guided you that you should go for being a doctor, because our three generations were doctor or engineer, you should follow that. You are totally confused what to do now. Right or wrong? You are connecting with the agenda which I am trying to share with you. You can see the engineering, which was once most sought out stream. You can see that Infosys, Wipro, you know, healthcare industry, if I talk about the company Thyrocare Technology, is the most well-known path lab, you know, and it used to hire more than, 1,000 technicians, maybe 7 to 8 years back. Today, with just 100 or 200 employees, it is doing more than 10 times output it is producing. You know, with less manpower, output has grown 10 times or 20 times more. So you see, the machines are now ruling the industry. And where the mankind finds its own place is something which we need to introspect, and we need to prepare ourselves for the future. Okay? Can we move to the next slide, please? Yeah. This is the quarterly report. All these industries, you can see textile, leather, metals, automobiles, gems and jewelries, transport, IT, BPO, handlooms, power loom sectors. More than 43,000 jobs have already lost in the first quarter of 2015-16. Okay, and there has been no recovery in 2016, and it is still on the decline. So these industries at once produce maximum jobs, and today the job sector is declining. You can see in the financial sectors also, JP Morgan, Goldman Sachs, Crom, Avanta Group, they have all started squeezing their businesses, closing down their one or the other branches, and they are trying to concentrate it on a few sectors or few areas only. So in all the sectors, if I go, Zomato, I'm sure you know about this, online food, order portal company, Zomato, they have laid out 300 employees, they have, laid off. So 10% of its workforce last year. So you can see, why such a high rate of joblessness? You need to understand that. Yes, next slide. Lack of private investment, increasing mechanization. Okay, they want one person, because I have been in the recruitment industry for 9 years out of my 14 years, recruitment industry in US and Indian market. And I have interviewed so many thousands of candidates, searched so many profiles. What the current employers need is one single person should be able to do 3 or 4 multiple things, which was once done by 4 different people. So you have to be jack of all trade and master of all. Today, it's not like jack of all trade and master of all. Jack of all trade and master of all. Now you see what the industry is looking for. There is one job vacancy, 10 job vacancy, 200 job vacancies, and the number of applicants will be 20 times, 50 times more than that. I still remember, after my engineering, I got already 2 offers, and still there was an opening with Rolta India, which is a well-known company in Mumbai, SIPS area, Rolta, in automation and GIS and so many geographical information system and all. It is a well-known engineering company. Several buildings are there, towers are there in Mumbai area, software area. When I reached there, I wanted to be a marketing professional since my college days. But since I was already an engineer, my father wanted me to go in engineering. So I went there, but when I went there, I thought, is it some pool booth or for voting people are standing? I was quite amazed by seeing the scenario. Around 3,000 plus candidates were standing there with their biodata outside the building. All engineers and MCAs, and the jobs were around 500 or 600 vacancies were there. So I said, my God, I came in a relaxed mood. I thought I have been called for the interview. I'll straight away get into the building, give my interview, and I'm sure I'll be selected and I'll go back by today's train. What is this? I stood there. However, my luck favored me. They said, if you, you know, make 2-3 rows and who have the GIS as an option, they are allowed to go first. Geographical Information System. Luckily, I did some study that what this company is into through the job site and all, you know, their website and all. So I knew. So I went there inside. I got the chance first. Even after the written test and all, GIS was my subject, so offered me because they wanted someone already knowing GIS. So in my college days, I opted the right subject. What I want to tell all of you is, you have already opted a subject. You are all from which stream? Science and other streams also, or only from science? All science stream? You have chosen, how many of you are here from computer science? None from computer science. No one has opted computer science. I mean, is there a batch of computer science students also? Okay. So here you all have chosen what stream? I mean, apart from, what are your subjects actually? IP, you say then? Acha, this is the, so here you talk about computers only or, okay. What are the programming languages you all are being taught in the school? Java and all, okay. Scripting languages you are being taught? Any web scripting language, JavaScript and all? Okay, HTML, okay. But I'll tell you what, in the schools now, there are schools in Delhi and all who have already started, you know, because I'll tell you the recent development, Udaan has been given the approval by the Directorate of Higher Education, Government of Delhi, to run its Udaan projects in schools and all the colleges funded by Delhi government. So we are running AI, artificial intelligence and other programs also. You know what? 10 years and 12 years old children are now opening their own companies. It is already in the news. In Chennai, a 10 year and 12 year old brothers, siblings, they started their software company, they wrote apps and all, and now they are $300 million company. And I'm talking about competitions rising up. You are seeing, you are living in the age of reality shows, where the students at the age of maybe tender age of 5 and 6 and 7 are making their career while coming on a dance show or a music show. At our time, or maybe even at your time, when you were so young, I'm sure that was not the scenario. But today, the chalo khelte hain has become the slogan where the sports have taken the front stage. They are becoming the superstars now. Musicians, dancers, you know, painters, writers, Chetan Bhagat, you know about Sankar Mahadevan. He's an IITian. He's from IIT Madras. Okay. Kumble Sahab, Anil Kumble from NIIT. You know, when he took 10 wickets in a one inning against Pakistan, he was asked how you did that. So he explained, I use my physics phenomena here, that the wind was blowing in this direction and I did my, you know, I threw the ball, I balled it in the right direction, in the wind direction and all that. He gave his logic. So I'm telling you why. Today, when you are using your education in the right direction, only then you can get the success. If you are going in that same race, like everyone in my class is applying for this, let me also apply. You won't get that kind of success or stability in your life. Why? These scenarios are talking about it. Can we just move to the next slide, please? What are experts saying? And I would like if you can note down a couple of things which are like stats for you to make a good decision. Because after this one, maybe if you forget, you have some statistics with you to note down and refer that what research do I need to do. And then I'm going to come to towards the end of the program, I'll be asking you, which are the top 10 jobs in the world? By the way, let me just do a little survey, which are the top 10 jobs in the world? Just a wild guess. Top 10 jobs, you can, there is no point for it, you can just say it right away. Anything which comes to your mind, don't think too much. Loudly, loudly. CEO, very good. Then, tell me, whatever. See, there is no right or wrong. You can just tell me. UPSC, okay. Then, management. Software development, very good. Then, doctors, very good. Loud, loud, loud. You know so many career options, you can just, fashion designing, very good, then, army, very good. Okay, so I have taken this many options. In the middle also, if some option comes, you can tell me. So more than 10, we have already spoken already. So let's see how many of them are there in the top 10 jobs. Because this is what information you all also have. Your teachers also have the same information. And your parents also have the same information. I'll tell you, growing unemployment in the country is just because of this knowledge only. How can UPSC be the most desired job in the world when UPSC is in India? UPSC exam is in India, na? These are the informations which you have got it from your parents, from your teachers, from the society. Okay, which is, name one IIT which is in top 200. Which is that IIT? In the world, top 200 colleges in the world. Which is that IIT? Kharagpur, Roorkee, Mumbai, Powai, which is called, okay, Delhi. In this way, toh, okay, how many IITs are there, by the way? 23, very good. You are right, 22, at least close to that. And how many seats are there through IIT JEE? Since most of you are talking about engineering, I am focusing right now on engineering. Is there someone doctor, future doctor also here? Okay, thank God, at least two of them. And mostly in the schools, I find the girls raising the hand for the doctor. Here two boys are there at least, thank God. So two doctors, future doctors are here. And I can see one of the students doing the recording part. I feel that you are passionate about this profession. Okay, good. At least there is some alternate career for this. But I don't think anyone has said they want to be a photographer in their life. All have been talking about engineering and, you know, sophisticated engineers. And they have told about top 10 jobs, so many things. Let's see. And you also see if anything comes in that top 10. That is the research by, not by me, that is by Microsoft. Okay, so I'm sure we all believe in Microsoft research. Okay, so that is not Ranjan. Yeah, Ranjan has done the work of compiling all the information from the world in UDAN, which makes it, it was the thing. Oh, we didn't know. Let that happen first. Today is only the eye-opener for all of you. So that you know that, we are lacking, we are preparing in this rat and cat race. Ye toh tha hi nahi hai, tha, dekhte hain. That is something which you will come to know. So what are the industries? Okay, so what I was saying, how many seats are there in through IIT JEE exam? Not in IIT only, IIT JEE exam, total number of seats or which are going to be filled by IIT JEE exam is what? 10,000. I am again repeating, not only in IIT, there are state colleges, there are NITs. You know that, okay, what are the two stages of IIT JEE? Mains and advanced. So, advanced is for what? IIT. But JEE is for till NIT. If you clear with, and if you really want to go in IIT, you have to clear advanced. So I'm saying by IIT JEE, I'm not saying by main or advanced. I'm saying main plus advanced, total how many seats are going to be filled? Dekhiye, banna to chahte hain sabhi engineers. Research kisi ne kuch nahi kiya hai. 18,000 this year is for IIT only. 5.5 lakhs. State colleges are also there, na? State engineering colleges, so many. 5.5 lakhs. Okay, and how many students appear every year in IIT JEE exam? 13 lakhs. Very good. 18,000 seat, 13 lakh. What percentage of the total students are getting into IIT? Do you think even 1%? Even 1% of 13 lakhs? No? And then my question comes back again on the same. Which is that one IIT which is in top 200? All the names you take it. But I am sorry to say not even one IIT is in the top 200 in the world. Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore is at, I probably around 190 rank. because of its world-class lab and research facility, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. And believe me, coaching industry is $150 billion business in the world. $150 billion business, and India itself has $50 billion business. And not even a single IIT in the top 200. Which really gave an alert message to our Honorable Prime Minister, who is known for innovative things. Maybe he is trying, but the old system needs time to be rectified. So he set up a task force to improve the standard of IITs in India for next 5 years. Because still IITs are following the age-old curriculum of 1950s and 60s. That is why Honorable Narayan Murthy Sahab, you know Mr. Narayan Murthy? Who is Mr. Narayan Murthy? Acha, do you know Infosys? Thank God. Infosys ke founder kaun hai? Hai na? Bhai, ye sab to basic cheeze hai. मैं डीपीएस में आ रहा हूं, ये सब तो मुझे उम्मीद रखनी चाहिए कि इतना तो यार जीके में तुम लोग बहुत तेज होते हो, बचपन से तुम ही लोगों के साथ कंपीट किया है. और ऐसा अगर जीके रखोगे तो फिर मुझे सही में लगेगा कि एजुकेशनल सिस्टम डिग्रेड हो रहा है. इन्फोसिस फर्स्ट आईटी कंपनी टू बिकम ग्लोबल, ओके, नैसडैक, यू नो, सो मेनी थिंग्स आर देयर टू बी टॉक्ड अबाउट. व्हेन वी डू अ लॉन्ग प्रोग्राम वी विल बी टॉकिंग मोर ऑन द data part, research part, and more useful informations. Right now it is all about, so not even one IIT in the top 200, and not even 1% of the students get into the IIT out of the total number of students who appear in IIT. But when we talk about innovation, I'm touching the points which are of concern to you and which should be of concern to you. What do you mean by innovation? When I use the word called innovation, what do you mean by innovation? What do you mean by innovation? Can just someone raise the hand and tell me? Because I will not be able to clearly hear if you all say in a group. What do you mean by innovation? Can you be a little loud? Own creativity, new ideas, you mean to say. Very good. That is called innovation. In the list of innovation, which is the most innovative company in the world? Apple? No. Google? No. Microsoft? No. Huh? Coaching industry? Wo to kabhi hai hi nahi. Kisi ne kuch kaha? Huh? Kisne Tesla pehle bola tha? I heard from him. Very good. Can we have clap for him? Most innovative company, Tesla, electric cars, electric gaadiyan banati hai. Most innovative company in the world, Tesla. And then second is Salesforce.com ka naam suna hai kisi ne? Have you heard about Salesforce.com? Cloud ke baare mein suna hai? Have you heard about cloud? What is cloud? What is cloud? Storage, okay. It is the most contemporary format of storing your data. Started with floppy disk in our time. And we have reached an era where we are talking about cloud-based storage system. Yes? Salesforce.com is the second company in terms of innovation. And then third, fourth, and fifth goes to pharma companies. But India has not found even one position in top 50. None of the Indian companies have found a place in top 50. That is shocking and surprising, isn't it? The country which produces the maximum engineers in the world, how is it unbelievable? It is totally unbelievable, isn't it? In 2010, I was sitting with the regional head of NASSCOM. Have you ever heard about NASSCOM? NASSCOM, NASSCOM. कभी कान में ये बात गलती से पड़ गई हो, NASSCOM? किसी ने गलती से बोल दिया और सुनना नहीं चाह रहे थे, फिर भी NASSCOM पड़ गया कान में. National Association of Software Services Company, that is an organization which safeguards the interest of the Indian IT companies on global level. Devang Mehta was the founder of NASSCOM. Devang Mehta, an IITian, who is no more in this world. He died in 40s due to a heart attack very early. But he was the founder of NASSCOM. Ab aapko jankariyan mil rahi hai na? Kyun jankari zaruri hai? See, you want to be something, but today it is not like that. Those days are gone when someone used to do a graduation in computer science and used to go to America. Today, you know about visas, how difficult it is to get the visa for America. And a green card is an impossible thing now. It will take around 25 to 90 years. When you will be the age of 104 years, you will get your green card. Just 5 days back, the news have come. The things have become more stringent. Still, yesterday we wanted to be an engineer. Today we want to be an engineer. Tomorrow we want to be an engineer. But how to be an engineer, and that also successful engineer. Do you want an engineer with a degree, or do you want to become an engineer with a job? With a job, no? I'm sure everyone wants to get a job. No one wants to be called, sir, I'm a very qualified engineer, but abhi main degree lekar ghoom raha hoon. Milega to I will also get an experience. I'm sure we don't want to end up, but that is the real scenario right now in today's India. And we'll see how many colleges are there in India, engineering colleges, in the coming slides. But let's see what the industry experts have to say. Mr. D.K. Joshi, Chief Economist, Crucial. In manufacturing, if 11 people were needed to execute a piece of work, we generated $1 million worth of industrial GDP. What is GDP? A decade ago, today only 6 are needed. Instead of 11, 6 are needed today. Okay, to produce the same amount of revenue. India's 7.5 growth is based on gross value added methodology, which is being debated, and the growth could be closer to 5%. In India, we are talking about jobless growth. In the current government, people have been saying there is no job. There was a time when they were saying unemployment, up to underemployment. No new jobs are being getting created. It is, government is facing the hard time in creating the jobs at least. So in that scenario, where will the government will be able to provide you the job? That is the challenge now. Whatever growth there does not seem to be translating into the job. Okay, either the growth is in the sectors that are not employment intensive, or overall growth is overstated. Now, you must have heard about, in your country, see, best school in the country, DPS, no doubt. But still you are the part of the society, the same society, where the most poorest of the person may be moving around you. And you have to see him, you cannot ignore him. Because realities are not far away from us. Today you are here because of the blessings of the Almighty, because of the hard work of your parents. But tomorrow you have to make your own living. You have to survive on your own strengths and not on your weaknesses. Right or wrong? You are getting the point? That is the harsh reality of life. So we have to know all these data. Where do we stand today? Then only I can talk about our training programs will help you out with. So why do we need a training program? We are studying in a wonderful school. Board mein 90% plus aa jayega. And then perhaps I'll get a very good college. And then after that perhaps a very good job. And then my life is settled. Life itna aasaan hai kya? Itna aasaan to nahi hai. These are all the fairy tale thoughts now. Where there was a time when, in our father time, when few graduates and lot of jobs. Today many graduates and few jobs. So the best will be getting the job. So what preparation do you need? In which area you should work? Do you need to introspect yourself? Since you are only in DPS and engineers are the maximum you see from DPS, so we want to follow the same legacy, or do we want to really master the other areas of employment and create a stardom for ourselves? I think there is a high time we need to introspect. What are we good into? Next slide, please. These are all the chairmen and all. There is a word called gig economy. What do you mean by gig economy? Ek term hai. People work on skill. What they say is they want mechanical with computers, or maybe mechanical with a combination. So they want multiple skills in a common person, you know, who can look after 2-3 domains at the same time. Aaj boli, sir, maine HR ki padhai ki hai, so I'll be a human resource professional. Or I am an IT engineer, so sir, please. With IT, sir, I am an MBA also. So I can be a good project manager. So if you send me to America, I can understand technology. At the same time, I'll be able to govern the team out there. I can do a good on-site and offshore coordination. And I can be of economical, you know, enhancement for the company because I understand management also. You know, an IIT with a MBA from XRRI or IIMs would be a good combination. You know, that is what companies are looking for. More, you know, right now, just few days back, Government of India for the first time has opened 10 positions for a joint director, I think. Joint director, yeah. 10 positions in different departments, one each. And maximum qualification they have written will be given the maximum credit. With 15 years minimum experience and joint director, I think that position name is, if I am not mistaken. Every department, shipping and aviation, agriculture, every will have, and they will report to the PMO office. So you understand, now things are changing. With maximum diversified kind of qualification, you can actually look for better opportunities. Okay. That is called current changing trends in India. Customers are seeking more productivity and value addition. They have become more demanding now. You go with the same Rin Sabun, that most popular one, the most oldest I can remember the brand. And they will be saying, other brands abhi Patanjali aa gaya hai. And that is more cheaper and with better quality. They will be talking about, so there is, within the market, there is a fight. There is a fight with the outside brands, with the domestic brands. So customers have a diversified kind of expectations now. They are saying that with the one sabun, with one soap, they are also giving a detergent powder. Or with a soap, they are giving maybe a cream. Combinations are not understood. With a soap, washing, you know, so you are getting a face cream now. So customers also want from you. So customers have become more demanding. More model of companies going to engineering and MBA colleges to recruit a staff is changing. Now the recruitment team, which is going to the colleges for recruitment, they want a smart candidate with good English speaking. There was a time when an engineer used to think, even if I don't speak, I'll get a good package because I'm good in engineering. I'm from IIT. And I forgot to continue with the same line. And I was asking you, who is Mr. Narayan Murthy? In his word, the founder of Infosys, only 10% of the IITians are eligible to be directly recruited on the project. Remaining 90 needs training. After recruitment, they need training. This is the situation because the students passing out from the schools and going to the IITs have deteriorated. The application-based education is not taking place now in the school. It is all about completing the curriculum. And the sample question papers, solving it out. The concept building is not at par what it used to be maybe 2 decades or 3 decades back. That is what is missing now, concept building, application-oriented studies. So that is another challenge. New technologies are coming into the market. ITES job, what is ITES? What do you mean by ITES? IT-enabled services. Do you know BPO industries? You have heard about BPOs, call centers, back office jobs. You know, it provides the maximum jobs in India after IT jobs, ITES. BPO, business process outsourcing, BPO. Have you heard about the word called outsourcing? Outsourcing, America outsourcing its software work to Indian companies like TCS, Infosys and other companies, Wipro and all. So outsourcing, now the outsourcing is shifting to Philippines and other countries now, which are even providing much cheaper workforce than India. And now they are working on English speaking, you know. So that is what, it is another big challenge for India. There was a time when India was nominated for or was given the privilege of hiring those English speaking boys and girls for call center. Now English speaking is moving to the other countries. Rural, you know, there are campaigns like Digital India, Skill India, Startup India, Make in India. So the format has changed. The government is now talking about entrepreneurship, businessmanship, new businesses to start in India. This reminds me of that dialogue which I had with the regional head of NASSCOM in Delhi, which I was talking about. He said, and I was very proud of India till that time in terms of innovation. I used to think all the big companies are in India, so we are the most innovative company country because we produce the maximum software engineers who are considered to be the most smartest species on this planet. That is what I had, because I am from an IT background, B.Tech Information Technology. I think we use the maximum logics, so we feel that all the Boolean expressions are only found in our subjects. Okay, so I was telling him, so India is known for innovation and we have the maximum talent and all this I was talking to him. So he was just smiling and he was working on his laptop and he said, Ranjan, last time when did you hear any Indian company known for its innovation? I said, Hotmail.com. So you have heard about Hotmail.com?
Yes.
Who was the founder of Hotmail.com? हाँ भाटिया तक आया है मेरे कान में जोर से बोलिए सही बोल रहे हैं समीर भाटिया थोड़ा लाउड इन दिस वर्ल्ड ना फ्रॉम द लास्ट बेंच यू हैव टू मेक योर वॉइस नोन टू द पर्सन हु इज सिटिंग इन द फ्रंट बेंच देन ओनली यू विल बी नोन टुडे वर्ल्ड इज ऑल अबाउट कम ऑन आई एम एग्जिस्टिंग इन दिस वर्ल्ड हियर टू मी इफ योर वॉइस इज नॉट लाउड एंड क्लियर एंड इवन इफ यू नो द राइट आंसर यू विल बी लैगिंग बिहाइंड दैट शोज योर कॉन्फिडेंस सर समीर भाटिया That shows, okay, immediately whole house will turn back to see at you, to watch you out. Oh, he is the guy who knows the answer. That is how the scenario is in the job market. Who speaks first and who makes himself or herself audible and watched out at the earliest will get the first job. Okay? So, I said, Sabir Bhatia, hotmail.com. He said, very good. But then it got bankrupt and it was sold to which company? Yes, someone said rightly, loud, Microsoft, very good. Now, even if you write www.hotmail.com, the page will open msn.com. You can use the same Hotmail ID to log in, but then, good afternoon, ma'am. So, same MSN ID will be opened. He said, after that,